SAS's visual forecasting lets you forecast hundreds, even thousands of forecasts very quickly and automatically. Most of these forecasts will have high accuracy, but there's always a few troublemakers. SAS's interactive modeling node lets you hone in on those troublemakers, those forecasts that don't have good accuracy, to try to figure out how you might improve their forecasts. In this video, I'm going to assume you already know how to use visual forecasting by SAS, and I'm going to walk through using the interactive modeling node. The SAS Visual Forecasting Interactive Modeling Node can do quite a number of things. It can explore diagnostic plots so you can figure out how you might improve your forecast for a specific time series. You can create your own models. You can visually compare multiple models, including your models that you've created, to the system-generated models. Also, you can manually set a champion model. Let's jump into the software. Here I have a number of data items. These are electricity generation data. You can see I have the date variable, which is the time roll. You always need a time roll with forecasting. And then my dependent variable, or my target, is the generation in megawatt hours. I also have energy source and state as bivariables because I can look at each type of energy source and within that each state. In the US to see how much energy was generated. And I also have crude oil imports and crude oil production as independent variables or X variables or inputs. From the data tab, I'll move to the pipelines tab where I've already created a pipeline that has my data node, my auto forecasting, and then my model comparison and output. What I'm going to do is I'm going to right click on that connector between auto forecasting and model comparison. I'm going to go to post processing and select interactive modeling. Now I'll right click and run this. Now I see my partial pipeline run has completed. I can again right click my interactive modeling node and open it. I come initially into my modeling tab. I can start over here on my forecast tab, so I'll go to that one first. I see I have a lot of things on here. It's a little busy. I can go to my envelope plots and turn off actual values and predicted values, and I just see my actuals, predicted, and confidence intervals. So my actual values, this is for the whole time series. You see I have the selected series of one, series 269 of 269 series. This is everything in my data set. I have my actual values, which are the dots. I can turn those off. I have my predicted values, which is the line. I can turn that off also. I can turn back on the predicted value and my confidence limit and turn back on my actuals. This is for everything, but let's say I want to zoom in. Let me first look at wind and California. And you see I get a nice view of that. And then I will look at natural gas. And over here on the right, if I want to select a specific series, let's say I want Pennsylvania, natural gas in Pennsylvania, I'll select that. And I can see natural gas in Pennsylvania from before 2002 to the end of 2013, and then a 3-year forecast. So you can see that even though it says 51 of 269, I am only showing here the natural gas PA, which you can see I've selected. I can switch around to different states very easily. But let's go back to Pennsylvania and let's look at the modeling tab. So here you see I have three models. These are the automatically generated models that were generated with the auto forecast. We have an Aramax model, a Regarima model, and an exponential smoothing model. We can look at the details here by rolling over, or also we have this little details icon. And that shows me the details of that model. I'll close this. I can select the different models. I can look at diagnostic plots. So under diagnostic plots, I have forecast, which includes historical and forecast region. Oops. Forecast region only. Historical region only. And seasonal cycles. I can expand this with my arrows here if I want to get a better look. I also have model fit where I can look at my parameter estimates. So this gives the values of the parameters, and I can see that the values of my parameter estimates right here for each of my parameter names. The standard error of the parameter estimate, the t-value, and the p-value. And if I scroll to the right, I can see more information, the data set variable, the variable type, dependent input. My input is the same as my independent. The transformation, the factor, the lag, the shift, the model variable, the model label, and the selection list. Under model fit, I also can look at my statistics of fit. And there are a ton of these. You know, my mean absolute error, my mean absolute percent error, which is commonly used in econometrics, and so on. My Akiiki information criterion. Everything that is available, you know, which is pretty much everything in the statistical world, is available here in visual forecasting, you can see here. I can also look at my basic error analysis. I can look at my prediction errors. And I can look at my prediction errors as a histogram. And I have all my autocorrelation functions. So I can look at my autocorrelation function, my partial autocorrelation function, standardized autocorrelation function, inverse autocorrelation function, my white noise probability test as a log scale, etc. Using these diagnostics and our knowledge of forecasting, we could create our own models. Let's create a model now. What I'm going to do is duplicate one of these models, create a copy of the selected model, I'll rename that Beth Custom Model, and I'll add an intercept, and save. Apparently, I already have one with this name, so I'm going to edit it. Edit selected model. And I'll call it Best Custom Model, and I'll put today's date. Now you see I have my own custom model in here, along with the models that were created by the system. And I can look at the diagnostics of this model. And I can, for example, toggle between these different models, and you see the white noise probability test at the bottom updates. Finally, let's look at series analysis. I I can do a basic analysis like a histogram. I can look at my inputs. So I have my crude oil production, and I can look at a histogram of that, or seasonal cycles. So I can look at both my dependent and my independent variables in a number of ways. I can also do my autocorrelation functions. So I'll do my partial autocorrelation function. And so on. You see how extremely helpful this is. If I want to open up one of these, I can simply go to the one I want, for example, seasonal cycles, view details, and I get a large view. Here I can see either the graph view or the table view or both. Once I've determined the model that I want, on the modeling tab, I can set it as the champion model. So let's say for some reason my model did actually not beat out the best model, but let's say I wanted to set it as a champion model anyway. I can simply select it and hit this icon and then commit changes. I can also compare all my models. So if I select all of these and select Compare selected models, I can easily see how they compare. So let's look, for example, at our MAPE. And we see that the best model was the first model. And this is by default what is used to select the champion. But let's look at some of our other, let's look at, for example, our root mean square error. We can see that a different model was the best based on the root mean square error. Likewise, we can look at our Akiiki information criterion. And we see again that the exponential smoothing model was the best based on that. Not only can we can compare them by the selection criteria, but we can also compare them visually. In a graph below, you can see the different models compared as well as their confidence intervals. So we see how extremely useful is the interactive modeling node in SAS Visual Forecasting. For more information, see Joe Katz's video on interactive modeling in SAS Visual Forecasting for May 2021 and look at the documentation.